My Kalermo, this is your boy Drew, aka Drew That Warrior. Yeah, something really did break there. So it's time to leave now before the police arrive, so let's go ahead and do that. Alright, so far there's been some bad, juice that has been spilled with, Drew's parents. Andrea is not telling him exactly the truth, but I feel she should. But we're gonna go on to what's happening for now. Currently.
See you over there, Pac. It was great catching up.
Congrats on the high fame.
Thanks.
I told you we shouldn't have stopped to talk to X-Pac. That took forever.
It's gonna be fine. And besides, we got a great diet tip out of it with that mustard thing.
Red, I'm a huge fan. Can you sign this for me, please? Wow. It's been a long time since I've seen this. It was so inspiring to see you come out of nowhere and make that run to the finals. That last match against Rhea Ripley was amazing. Thanks for supporting me for so many years. It really means a lot. Sorry, everyone. We're running late.
For someone who's in such a big hurry, you have plenty of time to stop and sign an autograph.
She had a May Young Classic program the year I was in it. I had toured royalty. And we wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for that match versus Rhea Ripley.
Against Rhea Ripley, another jacked person. Evans is probably taking an interest in.
Coming up next is the tournament final of the 2019 May Young Classic. What started months ago with 32 women from around the world now comes down to two. Let's take a closer look at the distinct paths Red and her opponent Rhea Ripley took to get here tonight.
Rhea Ripley is a big force to be reckoned with. He's a very dominant competitor. And no doubt she would definitely be NXT champion or women's champion.
This is my third May Young Classic tournament. The first year, I was just happy to be here. Last year, I made it all the way to the semifinals, but this year will be different. This year, I win it all. There is no other possible outcome. You know, I almost feel sorry for Red. Because tonight, I'm going to annihilate her. Nothing personal, mate, just more of a wrong place, wrong time sort of thing.
The nose rings are kind of off, but there's something with the accent.
A lot of people think I came out of nowhere to make the miracle run to the May Young Classic Finals. I hate to ruin a good story, but I'm not the underdog. I've put in the work and paid my dues traveling up and down the road, defeating anyone who stood in my path. This list drives everything I do. Two years ago, when I was passed up for the first May Young Classic, I wrote on here that I would someday win it. Well, someday is tonight. Rhea Ripley, you can talk about how it's your turn to win, but I've got some unfortunate news for you. I'm taking your turn, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Strong words from both challengers. Someone's gonna have to back it up. Will Andrea dethrone Rhea Ripley? Or Rhea Ripley continue on with her dominance?
No matter what happens, you've made it further than anyone expected, and you should be really proud of that.
I couldn't agree more.
Oh, and it's probably not the best time to bring this up, but I found out Rhea Ripley had a custom jacket made that says 2019 Mae Young Classic winner.
Seriously?
Yeah. Pretty disrespectful if you ask me, since clearly she's beating you as a formality. I mean, she must have been really sure of herself to spend money on that. It's not like you can return a custom jacket. And you should see the detail on it. Even had a picture of your face with a black eye. The resemblance was amazing.
I'm going to tear Rhea apart and make my own custom jacket out of her skin. I can't believe Rhea did that. Not a smart move on her part.
She didn't. I just made that all up to motivate Red.
Sometimes her anger can be used for good.
Smart. Very smart. Gonna need all the anger she can to dethrone Rhea Ripley. Time for entrance. She just want to get this fight on with. That bell rings. And here we go, match is underway. And you can say that Drew did warm her up, going straight after Rhea Ripley. Oh man, Rhea Ripley's gonna be so like, oh man! What a spear right there from Rhea Ripley. And it did not keep Andrea down as Andrea continues her offense on Rhea Ripley. This is indeed a battle right here. Andrea starting off with the offense on Rhea Ripley. And the offense is all in Andrea's corner. That's a good thing. Keep the offense on Rhea Ripley. Never let her do the strength. Never let her at all do her strength, because if she gets her strength in, she will have to dominate. Oh man, look at that. Flying kick right in the corner. A great reversal from Rhea Ripley. Uh-oh, trying to go for something there. Did not work out. Andrea also trying to go for something. What a shot right there from Rhea Ripley, and another spear right to the ribs. The offense continues here on Rhea Ripley. So far, Andrea has been in control. Rhea Ripley. Isolating that strength.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, man. Face. Like planting her right there with that inverted DDT.
If you look up bad attitude in the dictionary, I'm pretty sure you'll see Rhea Ripley's photo right there on the page.
Oh, what a slap. Now Rhea Ripley finally able to turn this around. So much offense right into the matchup. Now it's able to turn this around. Like I said right there, smart strategy right there, avoiding that strength again. And now it's stalking Rhea Ripley here. Doesn't matter about a bad attitude, she's still dominant. Inverted DDT did not do it for the three count right there. What a German suplex, but too close to the ropes. Had to break up the pinfall. All up to the top, this is a specialty right here. Much of life flyers right into the cross body. 4-3 count. Shoulders down, but the kick out. Weighing Rhea Ripley down. Very smart thing to do right there. Now that.
Simply said, this is going to be a great match.
May I hit right there too soon? And now he's gonna pay for it with the suplex.
You're not gonna get it that easy. Still a lot more fight left.
Still staying alive is Andrea. Iris went right into the corner. Avoiding whatever she was looking for right there. Another inverted DDT. Continues to stay alive. The match these two have put on so far. I think it's something here to try and get the offense continuing in our favor. Did not want to do that. Oh, and I paid the consequences. Only Ruby has the full control going this right now. What a kick right to the back of the neck.
She's got her.
I said before, when a mistake is made, then the offense gets turned right in an opponent's favor. Tossing away from us. Stalking Rhea Ripley again. Detonator. And a three count.
Not to get ahead of ourselves and take away from this moment, but you do have to wonder what's next for Red.
We'll have to wait and see, but clearly she's put herself on the map
with the decision makers here in WWE.
Our emotions getting the best of Rhea Ripley. This is not how she envisioned this night ending. Nonetheless, congratulations again to Rhea.
Alright, so I think on the list was win the Mae Young Classic. I'm pretty sure that is off the list.
I'll take it.
You need a free hand anyway.
Win Mae Young Classic Tournament.
Done.
That trophy was supposed to go home with me tonight.
Yeah? Well, maybe next time don't assume you're going to beat me.
I heard about your custom jacket.
What are you talking about?
I don't need to get into that right now.
Whatever. We'll finish this some other time.
Congrats again. You were really impressive out there tonight.
Thank you so much for the opportunity. So, if I can ask... What's next?
We have your info. Maybe we'll contact you for a tryout sometime.
I appreciate that, but I just won the Mae Young Classic. Haven't you seen enough?
We don't want to rush into anything.
Hunter, come on. He's messing with you.
Sorry, you're trying to have some fun around here. Look, the truth is we've seen more than enough. And we think you're amazing. And that's why we'd like to offer you an NXT contract.
Wow. I'm speechless. Thank you. This is everything I've ever worked for and dreamed of.
You've certainly earned it.
I just have one request.
Whatever it is, I'm sure we can make it happen.
I'd like you to sign my friend Trey.
Good one. I guess I deserve that after I messed with you.
I'm not joking.
What?
You need to think very carefully about what you're asking.
I already have.
You really don't have to. I know I don't have to.
But I want to. We're a package deal, remember? So if you really want to sign me, then you're signing him too. And if that doesn't work on your end, then I walk. No hard feelings.
I certainly wasn't expecting that kind of ask. But I respect your loyalty. That goes a long way in this business. That being said, your friend here wasn't really part of our plans. But if you want to vouch for him, then you have a deal.
Both of you.
Congratulations.
Are you freaking serious? What was that? You just risked everything for me.
Aren't you happy?
I am, but you stood up to the CEO of WWE like you were some kind of big shot. That was insane.
I admit it was a bit of a Hail Mary, but it worked, didn't it? We're best friends. I wasn't going to do this without you. That's the deal we made.
Well, thank you. It's the nicest thing anyone's ever done for me. And that includes getting adopted. I promise you won't regret it.
It was the right thing to do. Now just show them why you belong here.
I will. Hey, I just realized we can cross off another list item. Well, sort of. Compete on NXT.
Oh, yeah. We wrote that back when NXT was a reality show.
Close enough.
You know what? I actually give Andrea a lot more credit because now I am officially also on NXT. Because I want to just be playing with one person like throughout five chapters until I get on. I'd rather play between them both. Velveteen Dream. Dude, so charismatic. Alright, Triple H in Peyton Royce. Let's talk with the COO first.
I just want to reiterate that we had no intention of signing you to NXT. Possibly ever. But thanks to your friend sticking your neck up for you, that's obviously changed. So I suggest you make the most of this opportunity.
I will.
Wait, so are you saying your buddy X-Pac never mentioned me?
No, he did.
Oh, okay. So at least you have his recommendation to go off of, too.
I said he mentioned you. I didn't say it was good.
I figured.
I feel like I recognize you from somewhere.
Calgary?
Oh, I know. You look just like the woman in those TV commercials for IBM.
I think it's that scrunched up, miserable face you're always making.
I beat you in my first match ever.
Remember?
Sorry, it doesn't ring a bell. But congrats on winning that cute little trophy. Let me know if you ever want to step up and face some real competition.
I beat you before. Like she just said. I don't see real competition. Alright, so anyways, yeah, I'm probably not gonna get no more emails on that. So, winter is coming. I don't think I still have any more, stuff yet. Where's the buzz part? I don't know.
Thanks so much. Then why were you in such a hurry to get here?
Because I hate being late slightly more than the awkward social obligations. I mean, if one person says something dumb like, look, it's red on the red carpet! I'm going to strangle them.
Red?
Well, there goes my old wife.
She gets a little cranky when she's nervous.
Anyway, I've been covering the WWE Hall of Fame for almost 15 years, and I've never seen anything like this. We've had individuals, tag teams, factions, families, but never a pair of best friends inducted together. This is truly a special night.
It really is, Byron. But just because our in-ring careers are over doesn't mean we can't continue to give back to the business that gave so much to us. In fact, that's why I'd like to officially announce I'm available for commentary and hosting work. So, WWE, if you're looking to freshen things up around here, then you know where to find me.
Are you trying to take my job?
What? I'd never do that. Don't be so insecure, Byron.
Okay, well, that concludes one of the most interesting red carpet interviews of all time. Live TV, everyone.
What was that?
You're welcome for taking the heat off. And maybe I was auditioning for a gig. You don't want to stay involved in some way?
No, when I said I was done, I meant it.
Red, Trey, Velveteen.
Congratulations. But just keep in mind, it's one thing to achieve your dreams, but you will never be the dream.
Great to see you too.
See? That's why I hate these things. You run into all sorts of people you have history with. That was super awkward.
Yeah? Well, at least it didn't end with someone getting knocked out like back in the day.
Alright, so it was better than Byron's commentary, I gotta say that, so I would be good for commentary. But anyways, I guess we are going to a part where Velveteen Dream was involved.
Hey, where are you going? The show hasn't even started yet.
I don't have anything to do, so I'm leaving.
Seriously? You should stay. You never know what could happen. Plus, it at least gives the impression that you care.
I do care.
In fact, I care too much, which is why I can't take just sitting around doing nothing while everyone else gets opportunities.
We're still relatively new here. I think you just need to give it more time.
We've been in NXT for months and I've barely been on TV. And other than you, no one even knows who I am. It's like high school all over again. Right down to having to ask permission to use the bathroom.
Who makes you do that?
Cassius Ohno. Wait, is he just messing with me?
See, exactly like high school. Look, bathroom pranks aside, I think you're overreacting.
Really?
Watch this.
Hey, Ricochet. Good luck with your match tonight.
Oh, thanks, Troy.
He almost got your name right. That's a start.
If that doesn't prove my point, I've also asked just about everyone on the roster to be my partner for the Dusty Classic, and they all said no. Or worse, ignored me.
Okay, fine. Maybe there's some truth to what you're saying. But I still believe it'll get better.
Do you think anyone would catch on if you disguised yourself as a man so you could be my partner?
As much as I'd love to try to pull that off, I'm focused on beating Rhea Ripley to get a shot at the NXT Women's Championship. It's gonna be tough since she still hasn't gotten over the fact that I beat her in the Mae Young Classic.
But at least you have the Mae Young Classic win. It proves you belong here. My problem is everyone thinks I'm just riding your coattails. Well, you know what? From now on, I'm gonna ride my own coattail.
How do you plan on doing that?
I need to do something big to get people's attention. Something that'll change the narrative. And I need to do it tonight.
I like the fact that you're not just giving up and going home. But keep in mind, I put my reputation on the line by getting you hired here. So anything you do ultimately reflects back on me.
I understand. But you have nothing to worry about. Hey, do you know where I could get some handcuffs on short notice?
And now I'm worried.
Don't worry. I won't do anything that bothers you. Well, kind of. As long as I actually get to do something.
Before we get to that match, which my friend Red is going to dominate, there's something I need to say.
When I was signed to NXT, I was told to make the most of my opportunity. Well, so far, the only opportunity I've had is to sit in the back every week like some kind of glorified cheerleader, watching everyone else do their thing, while I ask myself over and over again why I'm not out here.
Maybe because I'm not good enough in the ring, or I don't have the right look, or I rub someone the wrong way.
Or maybe it's simply because my friend helped me get a job, and no one can see me as anything other than a charity case.
I could drive myself crazy trying to figure it out, but one thing's for sure, if I never get a chance to show what I'm capable of, how will anyone know if I deserve to be here or not?
Luckily, there's a tournament coming up that has put countless NXT superstars on the map.
The Dusty Classic. Only problem is, I've tried to find a partner, and so far, all I've gotten is a bunch of no's, blank stares, and who the heck are you?
But there's one person I haven't asked yet. Someone who calls themselves the Dream. But they've never competed in a tournament named after the real Dream, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
So I'm not leaving this ring until Velveteen Dream comes out and agrees to be my partner.
Wait, are you kidding me? Get this idiot out of the ring. No wonder no one wants to be his partner.
This is certainly an unconventional way of doing things.
I'm pretty sure you're not even relevant anymore. Corey.
He called out Velveteen Dream, and thankfully, here he comes. Hopefully to put it in his mess.
What up, man?
So?
Are you gonna be my partner?
Because as you can see, I'm not going anywhere until I get a yes.
The dream always keeps the spare handcuff key on his person. You never know when you might need it.
What a shot. Still waiting.
If you want the dream to be your partner, then you need to prove yourself by beating the dream in a match later tonight. You got the dream's attention.
Let's see if he can keep it. That was certainly unexpected, but Velveteen Dream has made a career out of defying expectations. I don't care how weird that was, at least Velveteen got the ball in the ring.
My best friend is out here. How is it? Things all yours now, Andrea.
What the heck was all that?
Do you ride my own coattail?
Well, maybe next time you're gonna hijack the show with my next.
You got this.
Well, you're always on TV anyway. I play with you too much. Gotta keep the offense on Rhea Ripley. Look at that, I just dropped you. Oh, look at that, right into a powerbomb. Got out quickly. Not gonna be enough just yet.
In case she loves to decimate opponents, that's what she considers fun. That's what puts her in a good mood when she's in the ring. Some people are happy when it rains, Ripley's happy when it rains.
How about this? Oh, try to go for the Phoenix Splash. Not gonna happen. We're gonna be scouting it ahead. Seeing it coming.
And again, yet another counter.
I love NXT. It's a great way to introduce the WWE Universe to the next generation of superstars. Nice contact there. She's taking a beat here. She needs to turn the tide here.
I could just try and go for the arms of Rhea Ripley, slow down her power. Like if she tries any of her power, it could hurt.
This is painful.
Oh.
And knee stop.
That'll ruin your leg.
she ducks out of the way.
That didn't work.
And a big right hand. Unloading.
Oh, man. What a shot.
Look at this.
Tell me right there with a powerbomb. Don't think that's gonna work. Yeah, I was right. I don't think she had no idea what she was doing, but okay.
Great one-on-one action here tonight. It doesn't get much better than this.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Rhea answers with a decisive big kick.
I beat her though. Oh, Shawn Michaels Triple H screwdriver.
I don't think we have one.
My shoulders weren't even on the mat. Regardless, like, I'm pretty sure I kicked her in the face and she was down, even though my shoulder was also on the mat. She win nothing. If she wanted to win an out cold match, she definitely won that. Alright, finally.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, weighing in at 220 pounds, Andrew the Warlock.
Guys, this match is sure to not disappoint. Especially considering who's involved here tonight.
You're absolutely right, Michael. This match will be one we'll be talking about for a long time to come.
So it's me versus Velveteen Dream. Velveteen Dream is a very tough challenger. Former North American champion.
Here at NXT, it's your new time!
Look at that entrance.
Velveteen Dream wants nothing to do with the likes of you.
This man. D-R-E-M. I honestly like this dude though. As they said, charisma, mic work, and the wrestling abilities. I'm gonna admire his entrance for a little bit more.
The real deal. His kid's got it all. WWE Universe. Intoxicated by the dream. How can he not be? So charismatic.
I finally don't want to skip it now because then.
Trey called out the Velveteen Dream to maybe be his partner in the coming Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic.
Luckily, Velveteen is here. That idiot is still stuck in the ring.
Oh, let's not forget Velveteen Dream and Andrea. If Trey can defeat him, Velveteen will be his partner for the Dusty Classic. There's a lot riding on this match. This guy Trey is only here because his friend got him a job. There's no way he's going to beat Velveteen Dream. Dream just barely got out of the way.
The thing between Velveteen Dream 2 is that he's only 26 years old, I'm pretty sure. 26, 25, I cannot specifically remember the name.
That was weird. What the?
I can't move.
Very nice. Breathtaking.
Yeah, that was not how I was supposed to go.
Somebody has to go up there.
A lot better.
Just stomping down.
Come on, waste it. Waste it. Waste it.
Yes. Just barely got out of the way. What's gonna happen now?
There is so much on the line in this one. Like they said, any given night, anything can happen here in WWE.
Dream just got out of the way.
Alright, so since I got him aware of health now, I can probably try to get him
to televised around the world in 18 languages and in over 110 countries. And you can see that Dream is looking overwhelmed. Yeah, he's being torn apart now. It's almost bedtime for Velveteen Dream. He's going to need to get back in this. Trey's setting up for a suplex, but Velveteen blocks it twice.
Velveteen Dream hits the neck breaker.
Maybe you'll find a partner next year, pal.
Yeah, I'm not waiting next year, though.
And now he's going to the top. This might put an end to Trey's hopes of competing in the Dusty Classic.
Purple Rainmaker.
Do it, Dream.
Seriously, another match lost.
Come on, cover it. What's the hold up?
Wait, what's Velveteen doing?
No, he's terrible.
Yes.
Velveteen Dream is letting Trey win.
I like you, Velveteen Dream. You are more awesome.
Maybe Velveteen Dream turned into an absolute nightmare. Velveteen Dream continues to be awesome.
He always does the unexpected too. And now I want to suffer another loss there. Even though it's just cutscene showing it. Alright, so, let's talk to the, Velveteen?
I let you win last week.
Because the Dream thought about what you said.
And I want to prove that I am the real Dream.
That's all this is. You're just lucky to be along for the ride.
I'm glad you didn't lose another match.
Okay, fine. But now that we're partners, shouldn't we discuss strategy or something?
Here's a strategy. Stay out of the dreams way.
That sounds very considerate, but I'll have to think about it. Well, you know what? Since I won the match, I'm very strong.
Hey, I ran into Triple H earlier and showed him your stunt last week was just a one-time thing. You're lucky he thought it was good TV, or you might be out of a job.
Triple H thought I was entertaining?
That's great!
That's not exactly what I would have gotten out of that statement.
Nonetheless, I'm happy you found someone to team with for the Dusty Classic.
Even if it's Velveteen Dream.
What do you mean, even if?
I just don't think he's the most trustworthy partner. But hopefully I'm wrong.
He's too set on proving he's the real dream to pull anything on me.
So don't worry, I'll be fine.
But what about your big contract signing tonight? Do you have anything planned?
Yeah, I'm gonna go out there and sign a contract.
That's it? These things are all about playing mind games with your opponent to get an advantage in the match.
Like, what if you brought your Mae Young Classic trophy to the ring with you?
That would really get in Rhea's head.
I mean, you need this some entertainment anyway, so this actually be interesting.
Okay. Since you seem to know about this sort of thing, I'll take your advice and bring the trophy out.
Great. So what did Triple H say about last week being good TV? Did he like my promo or the handcuff move or just everything overall?
You should focus on your match.
I mean, I want to know this information too. Why are you holding back? Heavy machinery. Why are you taking so long to respond to me? You alright?
I heard what you said last week about wanting to prove you belong in NXT. I respect that. But it's not going to come at our expense.
Why are you lying?
No, sir! Not at our expense!
What are you talking about?
We came back to NXT for one reason. To win the Dusty Rhodes Classic.
Back to win the Hitcher! You need to calm down.
I actually watched your previous Dusty Classic matches to try to get an advantage, but there wasn't a lot to go on.
You know, because you always lost in the first round.
You went there, huh?
You did go there. Sounds like he wants to fight!
Saving in the ring, big boy.
I'm just stating the fact.
Then here's another one. Tonight, we're gonna destroy you.
That's right, Ducky!
Okay. Just don't hurt my ear in the ring. That's all I ask. He's been having to change his title, though. I don't know what the next chapter on this is even going to be. So yeah, I'm just going to skip the entrance for this one.
Here at NXT!
curious to see what kind of chemistry Dream has tonight, as this is her very first time teaming together. And on top of that, facing a seasoned duo and extra theory with the Addison-based duo, Cassie Weston.
Speaking of mistakes, Heavy Machinery returned to NXT with one goal in mind. That's to accomplish something they were never able to do before leaving for WWE. Win the Dusty Classic. Now, trampling the opposition. That's what got it. He's in full control now. And now that one's countered. That was impressive, Michael.
And a great reversal right there from Velveteen Dream. Taking the offense right to Tucker.
Oh, that was just malicious.
This might be big.
Delivering the suplex.
Velveteen Dream delivering the full experience. Yeah, he's tapped into his reserves and he's going strong.
Now that's not right. Somebody do something about that.
Oh, Mike, I hope Cole's life isn't fair.
The better part of Balor.
Look at that. Oh, look at that, right in the famous.
Somehow has to find a way to make a tag here.
Completely agree. Getting the partner in here is absolutely vital.
I'll just avoid Tucker from,
It's the last few inches of her own to toughest.
And Tucker evades that one.
Ooh.
DDP.
Is it enough? Too early in the match to end it.
Had a hurt.
Tucker doesn't look defeated out there.
He's getting absolutely trounced right now, guys.
At this point, he probably doesn't even know which corner is his. It's pretty hard to make a tag when you don't know where your corner is.
I mean, that's true. I suppose. Excuse me?
In off the tag.
Ouch.
Oh, shoulders down.
Yeah, nice try.
I think he just put the entire WWE roster on notice with that victory. What a great tag team match. Thanks for watching, everybody.
So both of these guys get the win. I had Velveteen do much of the damage, but I still wanted to at least put the exclamation point on with a move.
NXT TakeOver, more history will be made when you compete in a triple threat match for Candice LeRae's NXT Women's Championship. Now, if you need to sign your names on the contract, we can make this match official.
Before we sign anything, I want to ask what you're doing out here with that trophy.
You think you're real cute, don't you?
This thing, I actually bring it everywhere. The grocery store, the gym, car wash, contract signings. I even sleep with it sometimes. Helps remind me of how I won the Mae Young Classic on my very first try. But who did I beat in the finals? I can't remember.
I don't have time for this.
You might want to stick around for a preview of what I'm going to do at TakeOver.
And thanks to Rhea Ripley, this contract signing has officially gone off the rails.
When do they ever stay on the rails, Byron?
Oh!
Rhea Ripley's going on a rampage.
And now Rhea is using the Mayhem Classic trophy as a weapon.
Oh!
Gets to bring it out here.
It looks like Rhea has some kind of eye injury.
No one deserves that, Corey.
At least she had charisma.
This is what I want.
I'm so, sorry. This is my fault.
No, it's not. Gave her charisma.
Tonight. She will destroy anything in her path to capture the NXT Women's Championship.
But that does not look like it's going to be good. But there's no doubt that she'll still pull it out. She's a warrior. And throughout how bad as the pain is, you always want to finish what you started. Or finish what somebody else has started. She beat Rhea Ripley in the past. She'll do it again. Yeah, we're just gonna keep going on here.
Here are NXT.
So who are our next opponents? The Street Profits. Gotta be sure Montez stays where he is.
Incredible.
Not getting a single tag.
Look at this. Struggling to get to the corner here.
Look at this. Purple Rainmaker.
Did Trey just tag himself in?
What is he thinking?
Purple Rainmaker.
Tribute.
Look at this clown celebrating. He stole the win from Velveteen Dream.
Why do I feel like this is coming to like a heel turn possibly for Velveteen Dream? There's just something a little too unorthodox for him to be celebrating, get a little too calmly. But just my opinion on it, on how I see this ending.
Officially been cleared to compete for the NXT Women's Championship against Candice LeRae and Rhea Ripley.
Ripley, who brutally attacked Red just a few weeks ago.
In addition to that enormous match, we also have the finals of the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic, where Trey and Velveteen Dream will take on the Viking Raiders.
Well, Byron, all your excitement, you forgot to mention that since the Women's Championship match is back to a triple threat, that also means it'll be no disqualification, which if you ask me, only means trouble for Candice and Rick.
Hey.
Hey.
I heard the good news. You were cleared. But you sure you're okay?
I'm only sure of one thing. I'm going to annihilate Rhea Ripley. She almost took everything from me, but her mistake was she stopped at almost. Tonight, I won't stop.
At least your match is no DQ. That way you can take care of Rhea and still win the title. So that's good.
I'd say it's very good.
Yeah, the eye patch is, Let me show that.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Yes. The dream's reflection is beautiful.
Right. Well, that trophy could be ours. But I was thinking, we still don't feel like a real team. And a big part of that is because we don't have matching outfits like all the great tag teams throughout history. So I went and had these made.
I hope you like them. I love them.
What is going through his head, though? But I'm not going to focus on that right now. What I'm more focused on right now is for Andrea to win the NXT Women's Championship and for me and Velveteen Dream to win the Dusty Rhodes Classic, I'm pretty sure it is. That trophy. Something's about to happen, though. Or it will just be both nights. Look at that jacket too, it looks awesome. You're gonna pay badly, Rhea Ripley. Yeah, always into the bodybuilders like you think, dude. But anyways, well, here we go. NXT Women's Championship.
NXT Women's Classic, before but never, would show the job on the line.
So I'm going straight after Ripley after she almost blinded me.
I mean, I realize she was cleared and she's obviously not 100%.
The real story is whether Candice LeRae will stop Rhea Ripley taking her title. As far as I'm concerned, that's a non-factor. I would never say that, Corey. Red's got an extra gear of anger.
And I think she might have to be able to use that for her advantage tonight.
Watch when I get that chair again, Rhea. Gonna have some problems. I want you to use that strength, like I said. That's gonna be the problem.
Right in the mouth.
To win that NXT Women's Championship. First thing you gotta do is take out this thing. I'm not done with you yet, Rhea. We have some problems that we need to take out right now.
Get her again, man. She really knows how to handle herself, huh? She's gaining momentum, guys. She's a lot of energy when she's plugged in. Just a step quicker. Right across the face.
Alright, Candice, I think you can stop right there. I'll deal with you in a minute.
She's in control. She got out of the way there. Her evasion techniques are on point. Oh, elbow high on the chin.
Okay, that didn't work out.
There it is. Oh, nice.
We still have some problems we gotta go through, Rhea. I'll deal with you later, though. Right now, I gotta wait again on Candice LeRae. Can never ignore the champion, but mostly more to revenge would it be going on for Candice. We've seen some of the matches in the past. It'll be interesting to see if we get more of the same here tonight. Uh-uh. Great Texas, O'Connor. Oh, man, what a boot. And a face. Dropkick right to the leg of Rhea Ripley. Good way to slow her down.
Things aren't looking good for her.
Rhea Ripley with that power. Look at that, that knee going right into the midsection.
Wow, she turned that one around.
Scoop slam. A great scoop slam right there.
This is a big risk with a payback.
Oh, look at that. That was beautiful athleticism right there. 4-3 count.
Too early for that. Nice kick, great elevation. Oh, nasty impact.
Oh, I thought I could, I guess not.
No, another reversal. Neither of them are going to win the championship.
That didn't work.
She's leaving the ring. What's going to happen now? What a shot.
Here's the pin. 4-3 count to pin the champion. Stays alive. That's the reason why she's champion. Now they bring this chair probably back into the ring. give me a minute here. Alright. Oh, can't get in the ring right there.
She just keeps using that.
Hey, look, you? So now, mostly one thing I should do right now is take out, Rhea Ripley.
She is just too quick. Gotta have your way in a hurry.
Hopefully one of them will be able to use their reversals. Don't know if none of them is going to be using the reversals just yet. I was wrong. I'm not sure glad I was. Uh-oh. Got a candlestick right into the ring. Try to use it.
There it is.
Now they're gonna deliver the damage. Look at that. He's going like unloading with that candlestick. After getting put by a table too, that's actually what he deserves. Very satisfying enough for me.
She goes to the outside now.
Oh man. Can just stick right into the ribs. Oh man, it caught me with a spear. Look at that. Inverted DDT. Everybody getting up to her feet now. Hopefully she is going to be using that signature. Doesn't look like she is just yet. Moonsault. Alright, so she didn't use the signature. I need to try and lure out how to do a finisher. Alright.
Look at this.
And a three count.
We just witnessed one of the gutsiest performances in NXT history.
I think I was supposed to pin Rhea Ripley there, but that's literally fine because I am the current. I'm not going to say that really because it's going to sound weird, but Andrea is the current NXT Women's Champion.
Velveteen Dream
Mr. Velveteeny, Trey and Velveteen Dream make their entrance together.
They've got brand new matching gear.
Looking good.
Maybe they turn the corner as far as your team chemistry goes.
It's one thing to wear the same gear as your partner, but the real test is going to be in the ring. If these two are on the same page when it really matters, the Viking Raiders are going to slaughter.
Look at Trey's moves. He's clearly been studying Velveteen's entrances.
All that time would have been better spent watching film on the Viking Raiders. But what's new? This guy's priorities have been out of whack since day one.
To be fair, Corey, Velveteen Dream is known for his eccentric entrances, but always delivers when the bell rings. So why can't Trey do the same thing?
Oh, that's easy. He doesn't have the same level of natural talent that Velveteen has. Besides, look at this guy. He looks like a goof on here trying to do Velveteen's mannerisms. If you're going to put that much effort into your entrance, at least get your own style.
He's just trying to be a good teammate.
It's all good fun.
Well, if this is your idea of fun, then that explains a lot. Nonetheless, these two have had an unexpected and impressive run to make it here to the finals.
It kind of reminds me of last year when Ricochet and Aleister Black were a somewhat unlikely pairing,
and they went on to win the entire tournament. We could see a similar outcome tonight.
Highly unlikely. The Viking Raiders have teamed thousands of times all over the world while Trey and Velveteen barely know each other. You can't overstate that kind of advantage.
I hear you, but look at these synchronized moves. I'm telling you, these two are ready.
I know one thing for Corey, he's so negative, but at the same time, that's just how he is. With his role. The main focus, though, is worrying on the Viking Raiders.
The two partners have to travel together, train together, eat together, and be completely in sync with one another. Saw it coming. Not again. One of these competitors is eventually going to have to gain the upper hand.
Again!
He got out of the way.
Got him.
Tag team competition dates back all the way to the early 1900s. I don't know who has the edge when it comes to talent. If it's Raw or SmackDown Live,
oh, look at that super kick.
Perfect as one unit. I agree, Michael. Teams such as the Usos, American Alpha, Anderson Gallows, the New Day, the Hardy Boys, Cesaro, and Sheamus. I could be here all day naming championship caliber teams. And when the tag team scene is that competitive, you don't know which team will be wearing the gold.
Alright, so this guy's really trying to get on my case right now. The strength there from Eric. I was put right in the corner.
Nope. Whoa, not so fast. Wow, what a sequence. What are they going to do here? Needs to make it to the corner. Oh, you're absolutely right. There's no way around it. The tag is vital at this point. All right, come here, Velveteen. All right.
Well, see, Velveteen Dream's going to finish this one and win this for the team. Look at this. Purple Rainmaker. A Dream Valley driver. He was me to hit it. Alright. What the?
Velveteen Dream is coming to his senses.
That is not how that's supposed to go. Oh my, this is gonna be really bad. Ooh. How many pounds on me? Velveteen Dream, how could you, dude? Come on.
Just happened, bro. Velveteen won just like I thought they would. Maybe we're going to get an explanation from Velveteen Dream. This is on you, partner. You called the dream out and you questioned the dream's authenticity. But the dream never needed some repulsive trophy for validation. The dream already knew that there was only one dream, and that is the Velveteen Dream. At one point, I considered letting you win this thing because the dream felt sorry for your desperate need for success. But then you repeatedly stole the dream's spotlight, leeching off the dream's moves, the dream's look, and anything else you can get your hands on. But it's like the saying goes, imitation is the sincerest form of bad.
Oh my. Try to get a swing in on that traitor.
Oh no. Are those handcuffs?
Oh man.
Just like this all started, this is getting out of the man's helpless. We need someone to put an end to this right now.
By no means advocating what's happening, but you have to admit, Trey brought this upon himself.
The moment he mentioned Velveteen Dream's name, he was asking for trouble.
Sure, he didn't do anything crazy to try and get attention. Yeah, like I was trying to disrespect him. Oh man, I just got straight out brutalized.
Red, Trey, you both have huge matches tonight. Do you have a second to comment?
No.
Yeah. We do. So Candice LeRae has invoked a rematch clause in an Iron Woman match. Now, after everything you've been through, are you ready for your first NXT Women's title defense?
Well, considering I'll actually be able to see this time, I think I'm more than ready.
Trey, you are going to face Velveteen Dream in the first ever No DQ Spotlight match, where in order to win, you must steal your opponent's finishing move. Now, how have you prepared for this unique stipulation?
I haven't had to. I've used his purple Rainmaker before, but he's never used my finisher. And on top of that, I might have another trick or two up my sleeve, because you never know when you might need it.
He has a strategy. I believe in him. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so for now, this is the end of this, but you know what? I am guaranteed to get my revenge on Velveteen Schrader.